a woman wrote on the ground, "The American flag propagates violence." The second that I started to shoot it, a man yells out, "Have that dog defecate on that shit."
No, have your dog piss on that, okay? Have your dog piss on that.
Anybody have any more chalk?
Piss on that.
Defecate on that garbage.
Let the Osama bin Laden and those people that love us know that our flag is obscene. We're not perfect, but Lord have mercy, that's written by an imperfect mind.
This is chalk. We can get rid of this.
Yeah.
This is chalk. It's not that, you know. It's not that bad. It's just chalk.
There goes the First Amendment of the United States.
Yeah, but you know what? If you're in the United States, you don't talk like this. Now, if you don't like the United States, you go home. We're grieving and there's a tragedy that happened like that. This is unacceptable. And I don't care how you cut it.
That was the part where I witnessed an hour-long confrontation in the middle of Union Square between the peoples of New York.
We're expressing ourselves. It's not about judging other people's opinions. It's about exchanging opinions.
And we respond. You write it and we respond. You can write whatever you want.
I'm a critique. I'm your Edgar Allan Schmo that put this filth down there.
It's a symbol of the country.
The symbol doesn't count anything. We
certainly
do. We are flesh and blood.
We have values. Did you think writing that?
What the hell?
I didn't write this.
I mean, every person was out there with an opinion.
We are superior to the values that have been propagated throughout the rest of the world.
Looking at those World Trade Centers, and now they're gone. Things that I grew up with are not here anymore. If they want to keep the war in their country, let them.
And somehow I became engulfed by all these people that were fighting each other. And they were at every corner of me. And it wasn't just one argument that happened in Union Square. It was argument after argument after argument, breaking out between people who wouldn't even talk to each other on the street.
Hide and harbor these individuals should will pay. Now, let me explain what's going to happen.
Not only ones going to war, like Bush saying, I think it's concentrating people's mind on war. It's not the poor. It's not the only one option. It's had to be more options.
The fight really was, let's not go to war or let's bomb the hell out of them.
I want the threat to be neutralized. And if that means erasing them off the face of the globe so my family can be safe, that's what I want done.
I don't like to wait until the Gulf War, until the bombs are going, and then it's too late. And then it's too late to stand with candles and say, we don't like to have a war. It's time
war
now
will
to
always
talk
be with us. There are military targets and there are not military targets. That is not a military target.
We're defending an ideal that is better than bombing against bombing against bombing against bombing.
Don't stand by and do nothing.
Well, we can't stand by and
that's
wait to
why
go
this
to
happened.
Seattle either.
Why this happened is because people wanted to let our intelligence, our military, and our
ready we're not using our intelligence
and who's not intelligent. That's why it happened.
We have propagated freedom and human rights and the liberation more than anyone else, of minorities and anyone else, and we are imperfect, but we are the most perfect nation that's ever been created, as flawed as we are, and I'll be damned if I'm gonna stand by and let people bomb us.
Then get out of the country.
That's not lies.
Well, get out of the country.
This European pantheism is gotta go. It's got to go.
What the Bible says, if you get a slam on one cheek, give your other cheek.
God gave us this country. I will stand to my death and defend it.
God didn't give you anything, okay? He didn't say the United States is yours. Because you know what? There were people here before. It's God has nothing to do with it. We live here no matter what.
People are disillusioned if they think we're going to just live in peace and harmony. And that's exactly how the Antichrist is going to rise.
I'm not going to fault anyone for what they said that day or for how long they fought for, because it was really just the frustration of being attacked, feeling unsafe, being unsure, your city being compromised, your life being compromised. Because it was emotion. It was just raw, gutted emotion.
And I want you all to fucking stop and shut the fuck up right now. I'm a local 580 lion worker. I was down there in the first 2 days.
And I want to
shut silence. I will. I was pulling body parts.
So was I on the first night.
Then what are we arguing about?
I don't know.
We're arguing. We're trying to.
You came here and told everyone to shut up.
chill.
I don't know. I am in fucking pain. Because I have never seen heads, body parts, and anything like that.
You can't act out in pain. You can't act out in pain.
Then what is one side arguing with the other? Let it be to our leaders.
Listen, I can't change ideas.
I'm not trying to fight. I don't know how to process this.
None of us do. We all have so much rage inside of us. And where is it? What do we do with it? What do we do with it?
We want to prevent this in the future.
We can't perpetrate the rage. We have to work through the rage.
Ow!
I'm sorry, I don't want to
hurt
anybody.
I know, but what do we do with it? We
have, I don't know.
There's so much emotion, it can't be, it needs to be channeled somewhere.
I have
or we're all gonna kill each other, I mean, it's true.
Why don't we stop arguing and start reflecting? That's what this bar is about.
No, we're arguing and then we're hugging, see? Argue, hug.